Good morning, Journey Church. It's a wonderful Sunday. Amen. Okay, you guys got the idea. Here we go. Now for you really coordinated guys and gals, throw that foot in there. It will be my joy to say your will, your way. It will be my joy to say your will, your way. It will be my joy to say your will, your way, always.
Keep it going, Nick.
When you found me, I was so blind. My sin was before me, I was swallowed by pride. But out of the darkness you brought me to your light. You showed me new mercy and opened up my eyes. From the day you saved my soul, till the very moment when I come home, I'll sing, I'll dance, my heart will overflow. From the day you saved my soul, when brilliant light is all around, and endless joy is the only sound. Bless my heart forever now. In your arms I'll always be found. From the day you saved my soul, till the very moment when I come home, I'll sing, I'll dance, my heart will overflow. From the day you saved my soul, from the day you saved my soul, till the very moment when I come home, I'll sing, I'll dance, my heart will overflow. From the day you saved my soul. Every moment when I come home, I'll sing, I'll dance, my heart will overflow. From the day you saved my soul, from the day you saved my soul, to the very moment when I come home, I'll sing, I'll dance, my heart will overflow. From the day you saved my soul. Praise this morning, Journey Church! Yeah! Lord, we thank you and we give you praise this morning. We lift our hands. We praise and worship you, Jesus. This morning, I don't have a scripture for you, but more of a story. I'm reminded of the time, somebody correct me if I'm wrong, but I believe it's Gideon. He was surrounded by the enemy, right? And all of a sudden, he asked God to open the eyes of his servant. And his servant saw the hosts of angels and armies of heaven surrounding, because he said, greater is those who are with us than those who are with them. And this morning, that's the message, is we don't need to fight our own battles. It says we just need to be still and let God, amen?
Spoke a word, you sing over me. You have been so, so good to me. For I took a breath, you breathed your life in me. You have been so kind to me. Oh, the overwhelming, never ending, reckless love of God. Oh, it chases me down, fights me alive down, leaves a 99. I couldn't earn it, I don't deserve it. Yourself away. Oh, the overwhelming, never ending, reckless love of God. I was your foe, still your love for me. Been so, so good to me. When I felt no worth, you paid it all for me. You have been so, so kind. Shadow you won't light up, mountain you won't climb up, chasing after me. Wall you won't kick down, lie you won't tear down, coming after me. Shadow you won't light up, mountain you won't climb up, coming after me. Wall you won't keep down, lie you won't tear down, coming after me. No shadow you won't light up, mountain you won't climb up, coming after me. No wall you won't kick down, lie you won't tear down.
shadow you won't light up, mountain you won't climb up, coming after me. There's no wall you won't kick down, lie you won't tear down, coming after me. There's no shadow you won't light up, mountain you won't climb up, coming after me. There's no wall you won't kick down, lie you won't tear down, coming after me.
Yeah.
mercy is the shade I'm living in. And you restore my faith and hope again. And all I did was this is how I fight my battles.
Look like I'm surrounded.
In case you're wondering, this is what it feels like to be in the presence of God. It's what that feels like. Man, God's going to do something amazing today, I believe it. If you guys will keep playing that softly, I think there's a good chance we're going to go back into that chorus one more time in just a few minutes. So typically during this time of the service, we pray for some missionaries, and we had a missionary we were going to pray for, but Chris Vidim's not here to get mad at me, so we're going to skip it this morning because I really feel like we should do this, and because I'm going to ask Dan and Sharon to come on up here. They didn't know I was going to do this, so they're probably freaking out a little bit. But I want them to come up here. I was going to pray for them at the end, but I just really feel like God is saying, let's do this now. So, for those of you who don't know Dan and Sharon, this is part of your family. And our guy Dan this might be his last Sunday with us for a little while because he is going to be deploying for 9 months or something like that. That's a long time. Going to be going to Kuwait, I think, and then off to Afghanistan, right? And so this is our family, guys. And hey, Nick, I see you in the back, bro. Will you come up here with us too, man? I want some. Ray, will you come up here with us? We're gonna pray with Dan and we're gonna pray with Sharon. Look, guys, this is our family. So I'm making a commitment to Dan right now that the men of Journey Church are gonna take care of Sharon while he's gone. Do you hear that, men? So if there's something she needs, she gets to call us, and I get to call some men and say, men, we need to take care of our family. And men are going to step up and do it, right? We're going to do that. We're going to pray with these guys. And if you guys want to come up with us, this is our family. Let's surround them with family as we pray for these guys. I can't imagine. I can't imagine being away from my wife for 9 months and you know, not being able to be there to take care of her and all that kind of stuff. It's a big deal. And you know, these are great people here. Let's pray. But God, in the name of Jesus, we just pray for our family right now. We pray for Dan and Sharon as they're getting ready to enter this new period in their life, Lord, as he is getting ready to deploy and serve the country and just do things that many of us would be scared to do. Lord, we pray, first of all, for a special blessing on both of them, Lord, a special blessing on their marriage. God, as they spend time away, Lord, that it's just going to create an even stronger bond, an even stronger love for each other as they think about each other. Lord, we pray for Dan. God, as he's gone, Lord, we pray that you would just protect him. God, just surround him with your angels. God, help him to do his job and do his job well. Lord, we pray that nothing will come even near Dan, that he will be safe and come back just as good as when he left. Lord, we pray for Sharon as she's here and she's spending time without her husband, Lord. We pray that men of Journey Church would step up, Lord, and help take care of her. Lord, that there are women in this church that will just befriend her and keep her company. Lord, that we will just surround this family with love, Lord, and just protect them and help them and love on them. God, we pray that when Dan returns, God, that Sharon and Dan's relationship is going to be even stronger, Lord. God, that it's not going to have any kind of damage done to it, Lord, that it's going to be stronger than it ever was as their love for each other grows as they're apart, Lord God. God, we pray for a special blessing on this family. Lord, even that this time will go by far faster than they expected. Lord, that it would just fly by and they would be together again, happy to see each other, more in love with each other than the day that they were separated, God. In the name of Jesus, we pray. Amen. Amen. It's going to be a great day. It's going to be a great day. We're not done praying yet. We're going to pray for our service. So some of you knew, some of you maybe didn't, but my boy Joshua's here today. Come on up here, Joshua. And Joshua He's feeling like he needs to do some praying too. Is that right?
That's good. Yeah, amen. Hey, I learned a long time ago that when we worship, the presence of God comes. And when the presence of God comes, God likes to do things in that. And we can sometimes move, and we do it, pastors, we do it. We move through our program. We have a schedule of things. But how many of you know when God's ready to do something, we just listen and we walk with God, okay? So this actually, I don't want to weird anybody out, but actually when I talked with Dusty before about coming and ministering, the Lord woke me up one night, and I had a couple of words, and it was for somebody here. Some people that were here. And it has to do with, first, there's some healings that need to take place here this morning. And I want to pray for some people. And usually we pray for the sick. And I'm sure that that's part of the services here. And if you have a sickness or an illness or a disease or some sort, some infirmity that you're dealing with in your body right now, the Lord wants to touch your body. He wants to heal you. Some of you have joint pain right now, and God wants to remove that for you, okay? Some of you are dealing with something with the heart, in your heart right now. I don't know if it's a rhythm issue or something like that, but you need God to touch your heart. And I just want to pray for some people this morning on that level. The other person, the other people that I want to pray for, and this is really the compassion of the Father. God is your Father. He's compassionate for you. Someone is not where you used to be 5 years ago. You don't know where you're at right now. There's some wounds in your heart. There's some pain. There's some pain, not because you did anything wrong, but because life happened to you and because the enemy came against you and fought against you because of the treasure that God has placed inside of your life. And right now, you find yourself in a place where you're not where you used to be. And I don't mean by financially. I don't mean with your job. I mean in your relationship with God. There's a distance there. And it's been hard for you to put your finger on that. And I know this is uncomfortable sometimes to say, hey, I'm not where I used to be with my relationship with God. And today I don't come before you as a pastor. I come before you as an evangelist. And my heart's desire is to see people come closer to Jesus. And I don't know what we're used to here, but I can tell you that the mercy and the love of God is here for you this morning. He wants to envelop you in his grace. He wants to envelop you. There's no condemnation for those that are in Christ. This is God saying, I want to refresh your soul. I want to turn the dial back to when joy flowed freely in your heart, where wounds were not there, where there wasn't this wall. Come on, anybody tracking with me this morning? Amen? Now listen, this is what I failed to do. There's an anointing here, okay? The presence of God is here. That's why we worship before we give the word, so God can move. Do we have prayer partners, Destiny? Pastor Destiny? Maybe a prayer partner's come forward. If you're sick in body in any way, now listen, some of you are sitting, now I got a sniffly nose this morning, but if you have a sickness in your body, the Bible says that by the stripes on Jesus' back, you are healed, present, right now. So, and I know many of you have testimonies of God's miraculous power, how he has touched and healed you. I want to pray for somebody who says, I need a healing. I got a bad report from the doctor. Or maybe you haven't gotten a report from the doctor, but it's keeping you up at night and you're worried about it right now. And God says, why are you worrying? Because part of the covenant promise in Jesus is that you can be healed. So come forward if you need healing right now. And if it's you that God's saying, I want to just pour out my spirit of refreshing over your heart, and I want to turn the dial back on your relationship with God. God wants to do that. He wants to heal hearts this morning. So come forward. There's no condemnation. This is love. This is Jesus. He wants to meet you here. Let's pray. And worship team, can you sing that chorus? Hallelujah. You have saved me. Can you sing that again? Just sing that over the atmosphere. Praise God.
do this for the rest of the day. But I know that God's got a message for us that he's given to Joshua, specifically for Journey Church. So we're excited about that. It looks like the kids snuck out while we were praying. That's fine. And what we're going to do, if it's your first time here at Journey Church, we just want to say thank you so much for giving us a chance. You know, we're so happy that you came to visit us. We hope you feel like part of the family right away. And what we're going to do is we're going to just take the next 7 minutes to just roam around the room, find somebody that you don't know very well or that you've never met, and get to know them a little bit better.